Midjourney has a lot of new features when it comes to changing the settings. So this lesson is going to be about exploring the different setting functionalities and how to use it for creating better outputs. So let's hop in. So for creating a normal prompt on Midjourney, we always type in /imagine. Now, for changing our settings, what we do is we type in /settings. So I'm going to do that now. So here is our settings panel with different buttons we can click through, similar to our U1, V1, and Remix options. Now, what I want to focus on first is the Remix function. So I'm going to turn this off, okay? I'm going to dismiss this to let the setting panel go away, and I'm going to scroll up to our favorite outputted car, okay? I'm going to click Vary Region. And what this is gonna allow me to do is highlight a certain part of the image. So we're gonna highlight the front grill. I'm gonna hit submit, and then Midjourney is gonna go to work only remixing that part of the image. Now I'm gonna open up the settings panel again, and I'm gonna turn remix mode on. What this is gonna allow us to do is when we vary our image, whether it's by clicking the vary by region or by clicking the remix button, it's gonna allow for us to put in a new prompt, which is really interesting. So we have the same part of our image highlighted, but I'm gonna put in a new prompt, and I want Midjourney to put a fighter jet engine at the grill versus basically deciding to do whatever it wants to do. So if we look what it outputted with the vary by region without a prompt, we only have subtle changes just to the grill and to the headlights, different colors, slightly different shape, different model, nothing crazy. But if we look at the fighter jet engine, Midjourney did a pretty interesting job of incorporating a brand new design just into this specific part of the image. This is a relatively new function that opens up tons of possibility. Now what I wanna do is use the same remixing function, but to create something a little bit more realistic versus this more cartoonish style. So let's go to our settings panel one more time, and I'm gonna make sure that remix is checked, because again, when remix mode is turned on, I can create a brand new prompt from what was previously created. So let's go to our initial output of just using the word car, and let's put something a lot more specific into this remix. I'm gonna use the prompt, a classic 80s sports car, photorealistic, restaurant diner in the background with the sunset, and let's say highly detailed, and hit submit, and let's see what we get. So let's scroll down and see what we created. Wow, and just like that, we completely changed the look and feel of our photo, going to something that an actual photographer could potentially shoot in a real life situation, going from that more cartoon fantasy style to something a lot more usable to use as reference images or just to really create something from scratch. In the next lesson, we're gonna dive into even more of the different settings and functionality of Midjourney.